Let's discuss about the limitations of Newton's law of gravitation, which we have recently discussed. About Newton's law, we can write that this law is only valid for point masses if masses are extended, or you can say when we talk about extended bodies, we can say on extended bodies, it cannot be directly applied. The reason is we have discussed about Newton's law of gravitation in such a way that if there are two point masses M1 and another mass M2, these will attract each other with a force F, and the magnitude of force can be given as gm1 m2 by r square if r is the separation between the two. And say for example we are having a large size object M1 and there is a point object M2. And we wish to find out the gravitational force of attraction between the two. We cannot directly apply it. Even we cannot concentrate the whole mass at its center of mass and apply the Newton's law of gravitation, because center of mass is a point where we can concentrate the mass as far as its inertial properties are concerned. When we talk about gravitational properties, it cannot be concentrated at center of mass. So the best way out in this situation is we consider an element of mass dm in this. Say dm is located at a distance r. It can be transformed vectorially also. Say with respect to m2, dm is located at a position vector r. Then we can simply state the force acting on dm due to this m2 will be df, and the magnitude of df can be written by Newton's law of gravitation. As here we can treat this dm as point mass, so it is gm2 dm by r square. And if we wish to write down the vectorial value of df, df vector is opposite to r vector, so it can be written as minus gm2 dm by r square r cap, as the direction is opposite to r vector, and it can be rewritten as minus gm2 dm by r cube multiplied by r vector. This is the way how we write the vector form of Newton's law of gravitation. And in this situation, we can find out the total force vector, which is given by integration of df vector, which is minus integration of gm2 dm by r cube into r vector. This is the way how we find out the Newton's law of gravitation, or modified form of Newton's law of gravitation, when we apply it on an extended body. It is always an integral of a point element considered within the extended body. Let's have a few applications in which we'll be able to understand how the force can be calculated. So here for extended bodies, we can write down a note that for extended bodies, Newton's law of gravitation can be applied by taking small elements in extended body and integrate the expression of force on element over the whole body, and the result of integration will be the total force acting on the body. So this is the way how we apply it. Like if we just take up an example, say we are given with a rod which is of length L and its total mass is M, and say the rod is AB and from its end A at a distance R, a small mass M is placed, and say the rod is having mass capital M, and we are required to find the gravitational force of attraction between this point mass and the rod. Then in this situation, if we concentrate the whole mass of rod at its midpoint, like which we have discussed we can't do, but if we consider and we apply the Newton's law, then this can be given as GMM by the separation will take as R plus L by 2. So, this will be R plus L by 2 whole square. But if we use the force, this will be a wrong result and we can't say that force is given by this value. Because if we talk about the force, we can say left half of this rod is closer to the mass. So, it will exert more gravitational force on the mass. And right half, as it is far away, it will exert relatively less gravitational force. And as these two parts are not exerting equal gravitational force, so it is not justified to consider their whole mass at a common place. As the rod which is located far away will be exerting a force which is less. So effective separation is more, and for this part effective separation is less. So, we cannot concentrate here the whole mass to be at midpoint of the rod, which is actually the center of mass. So, the best way out to handle this problem is by using the same method which we have written here. We'll consider an element on the rod, like at a distance x from the point mass. We consider the element of width dx. We wish to find out the mass of this element, it is dm, as for the length L mass is m, then this elemental mass dm can be written as m by L dx. And the force which dm will exert on this m will be attractive in this direction, say it is df. So we can write, if df be the gravitational force on m by dm, this implies this df can be calculated by Newton's law of gravitation as gm dm by x square. And in this situation, due to all these elements, the gravitational force is acting in the same direction, so it can be integrated. So, total force on m due to rod can be given as this total force is integration of df. And if we just integrate, this will be integration of gm. Dm can be written as m by L dx by x square. And it is integrated within limits from r to r plus L. Because x is varying from this end to the other end. So, it will be from x equals to r to x equals to r plus L. So, if we integrate it, the result we'll be getting is gm m by L. Integration of 1 by x square will be minus 1 by x and will substitute limits from r to r plus L. Let's continue on the next sheet. So, here on simplifying this, we are getting the net force acting on it will be gm m by L. If we substitute the limits, this will be 1 by r minus 1 by r plus L. This is the value of force we are getting. And this is the way how we calculate the results by using integration of Newton's law of gravitation over a small element of the body for the whole body.